Hello, welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to answer all of the questions and comments from the Easy Text Box video. There were questions on controlling the transparency, color, padding, 3D text, rounded corners, and more. In this video, I'll show you a more flexible way to create a text box in After Effects. So strap in and let's learn how the pros do it. Go ahead and remove all the effects so you just have a simple text layer. Select the rectangle tool and draw a box behind your text layer. This creates a new shape layer and we'll rename it to text box. Parent this shape layer to your text layer. Open up rectangle 1, rectangle path 1, and open up size. Alt-click on the stopwatch to add an expression. In the expression field, write const left top width height equals parent.sourceRectAtTime, and on a second line, write width height. Click out at the expression editor, and we can now see that our text box is the exact same size as our text. Open up rectangle 1 and transform. Make sure that in the transform group, your anchor point and position are set to 0, 0, and your scale is set to 100, 100. Hit P on the keyboard. If we move our text box, we can see that its position value is changing. Alt-click on the stopwatch for position and write the same thing as before. Const left top width height equals parent.sourceRectAtTime. On the second line, write left plus width divided by 2, on top plus height divided by 2. Now the background text box will always stay magically attached to the position of your text layer and always fit the bounding box of your text, regardless of changing the font, size, character, paragraph alignment, etc. Now that we have our text and text box as two separate layers, we can control them independently. Marie, Eberth, and Hassan asked how to make the text box transparent. Using this technique, we can. Hit T on the keyboard to open up the opacity. This controls the transparency. We can control the opacity of our text layer separately from the opacity of our text box. And we can control the color of our text layer separately from the color of our text box. We can add padding to our text box in two simple ways. Hit S on the keyboard to bring up the scale, and we can change the scale of our text box. It's that easy. But if you have a stroke on the text box, the stroke gets squished. So I prefer to add padding directly to the rectangle size property. Select the text box and then go to Effect, Expression Controls, Slider Control. We'll call this X padding. Duplicate it and call the second one Y padding. In the size expression, create two new variables for X pad and Y pad. Write const X pad equals, and then pick whip your X padding slider and add a semicolon. On a new line, write const Y pad equals and pick whip the Y padding slider. On the final line, change it to say width plus X pad, comma height plus Y pad. And now as we increase the sliders, we see that it's adding padding to our edges and we can control the width separately from our height. Controlling the padding from inside the size property also means that the stroke will no longer get squished. Omri asked, how can we curve the edges? Well, Omri, open up the contents rectangle 1, rectangle path 1. Below size and position, there's a roundness property. Increase this value, and now you have rounded corners. Or if you have a stroke, you can change line join to round join, and that gives you nice rounded edges too. Mike Falls asked, what if the text is a 3D element? Well, let's enable 3D on both our layers. And if we drag around our text layer or even rotate it in 3D space, we can see that the text box moves perfectly with it. To extrude the text box, open up Composition Settings and change the 3D renderer from Classic 3D to Cinema 4D. Our text may disappear behind the text box. To fix it, we just need to add +1 to the Z position of our text box layer. Search for extrusion depth and increase the depth to create a 3D text box behind your text. The text box still follows your text perfectly. Shane asked how to animate the effect. Let me jump in and help you. To animate this text box separately from the text layer, we can animate the transform properties within the contents group. So for example, anchor point, position, scale, skew, skew axis, rotation, or opacity. I'll quickly create an animation using these. Or if I hit S, we have access to the scale, and we can animate directly on the scale. For example, this will grow out from the center. But what if I want the text box to grow from the left, or maybe from the bottom? This is where the anchor point comes in. But if we select the pan behind tool and try to move our anchor point, the text box appears to be running away. That's because we have an expression on our position property. To fix our expression, simply write plus and pick whip the anchor point. Now when we move the anchor point, our position is also compensating for it. So we can move the anchor point to this left or right edge, and it will scale from that side. Or I can move it to the bottom, switch our scale values around, and it will scale from the bottom. Wherever our anchor point is, that's where the text box will scale from. As an animation bonus, I'll show you how to wipe on the text. Select the text layer and go to Effect, Channel, Set Map. Change Take Map from Layer to the text box, and our text will now be revealed on. Sandeep asks, I want a text box for each line of the paragraph. Is there a way to achieve it? To be honest, Sandeep, this one's tricky. I'll throw on a simple choker to our text layer to demonstrate. You see that bounding box around our entire text? After Effects is reading that entire bounding box when we're using sourceRectAtTime to read the width and height values. So the only way to have separate text boxes per line is to have multiple text layers. I'll duplicate the text layer and get rid of that simple choker effect so we're just looking at our text. Now you can see that we have two separate bounding boxes for our text layers. Let's move our new text layer to the bottom and turn our text box back on. Duplicate text box 1 and then parent it to line 2. Our text box rig works perfectly with the new parent layer. We can select line 2 and text box 2 and duplicate those to create line 3, and do this infinitely. This is how you can have separate text boxes per line. I hope you learned something new about text boxes in After Effects. Expressions in JavaScript can be daunting, but learning how to use them effectively will level up your motion graphics skills and help you automate repetitive tasks. For an in-depth tutorial on sourceRectAtTime, go watch these videos by Jake Bartlett and Nick Howell. If you want to learn more pro tips for motion design and After Effects, stick around and I'll release more videos soon. Thanks for watching and catch you in the next one.